Dear students, welcome back to my whiteboard program. So after a short interval of time, we are meeting with each other. So today we have to discuss class 9 science chapter 11 work and energy. Okay, so let us start. See here to the board. We have to start from work. What is work? What do you mean by work? It is very common word in our everyday life. Many times you are using this word work. But what does it mean? So if we'll see, work is said to be done by force of an object, on an object, if the force applied causes a displacement in the object. That means what? Suppose when we give certain force to an object and the object displaces from its position, then it is said to be work done. For example, you see here, this is the duster, it was there. So now I am taking this one and bringing to here. So I applied some force and I am displacing the object from here to here. So I have done the work, because I applied the force and the object was displaced. That's why work was done by me on this duster. So this is called the work. So many example you can take. Taking the stool, you see, taking the stool from one place to another place. So it is, the stool is changing its position, that is displacement, and I have applied the force. So I am doing the work. So this is called the work example. Let us see. What are the factors applied for doing work? For doing work, what are the factors are there? So there are two factors. What are these factors? Factor is the magnitude of the applied force, and second factor is that the displacement caused by the body. Here you see the magnitude applied force and displacement in the direction of the force. That is the two factors which depend, the work depend on these two factors. Let us see what is the SI unit and formula. So to find out the amount of work we have done, we can use one formula. Work can be denoted by W. Work is W. W is equal to, or work is equal to, force in displacement. Force into displacement. So force is equal to F and displacement is S. So W is equal to, mathematically, W is equal to F into S. So that is called the force formula. So let us see the SI unit. When we do the work, how much work we have done? So that is expressed by a word is known as the unit. Unit means what? When we express some physical quantity in magnitude, that is expressed by a word term. For example, when I ask, what is your age? What you will say? You will say, my age is 14 or 15 kg. Is not it? So no, you cannot say it is 14 or 15 kg. You have to say what? 14 or 15 year. You cannot say kg or liter, because for the age, we use one unit known as the year. Similarly, to measure the work, we have to use the unit joule. J-O-U-L. So that is called the joule. So the SI unit of work is joule. So 1 joule is equal to 1 newton force into 1 meter displacement. So this is called 1 joule of work. So what is called 1 joule of work? So when we apply 1 newton force to displace the object 1 meter distance, then that work is done is known as the 1 joule. In this way, we can find out how much amount of work we have done. So by multiplying force into displacement, we can find out. So this is about the SI unit. SI unit means standard international unit, which is applicable in international level. But sometimes we use some larger unit for the work, like that is kilojoule, megajoule and gigajoule. These are the three larger unit, that is kilojoule, megajoule and gigajoule. 1 kilojoule is equal to 10 to the power 3 joule. 1 megajoule is equal to 10 to the power 6 joule, and 1 gigajoule is equal to 10 to the power 9 joule. So that you have to keep in your mind. Let us come. The types of work. What type of work we do? Then it is surprise. What type means what? Work to work. Then what is the type of work? Let us see. Scientifically, we divide work into three categories. One is known as the positive work. Second is known as the negative work. Third is known as the zero work. Neither positive nor negative, but it is zero, means no work. Let us see. What is called the positive work? So when displacement takes place in the direction of force applied is known as the positive work. Positive work means what? W is equal to F into S. We apply force and the object goes for the displacement. In what direction? That direction of the force. If suppose, for example, this is the stick. This is present here. Now when I give the force it in that direction, in the forward direction, I am giving the force and the stick is going in the forward direction, then we call this is the positive work. What is that? That force direction and displacement of the object direction is in the same direction. Then we call that is positive work. For example, when we pedal the bicycle, so cycle goes in the forward direction and we pedal in the forward direction, that is positive work. When we open the door, we push the door in the forward direction and the door opened in the forward direction. So that is called the positive work. So that is called positive work. Many examples you can take. Then we will come to the negative work. When the displacement direction is opposite to the direction of the force applied. Suppose I am giving this stick in that direction. I am giving the force that direction. But by chance if this stick will come in opposite direction towards me, then it is called the negative work. Because I am giving in the forward direction the force, but the stick is coming in the backward direction. So the displacement is opposite direction of the force. Then that type of work done is known as the negative work. W is equal to F into minus S. Minus S for the opposite direction displacement. So this is called the negative work. For example, when we apply the brake on the cycle, vehicle, train, bus, whatever may be, to slow down the velocity, at that time the velocity slow down, the speed slow down, but the object does not stop or does not come backside. It moves in the forward direction, but the brake is given in the opposite direction, backward direction. So there are force direction and displacement direction are opposite to each other. In this case, we say that is called the negative work is done by the brake. So now we will come to the zero work. What is zero work? So very simple. If we will go to the formula of work, W is equal to F into S. So either one, F into S, you see F into S. If F will be zero, then the work will be zero. No displacement will there, no force is applied. So if F will be zero, then work will be zero, or displacement will be zero, means there, then the work will be zero. So if the force is applied but displacement is zero, means what? So for example, for that you just see here, I am just giving the force to this board. Now I am giving the force to the board, but the board does not move. You see, where is board? There is. So, but I am applying my force. I am just pushing my force. But still then board does not move. So here, what happens? I applied the force, but the board does not displace. So displacement is here zero. So F into zero. So that is called the zero. So work is zero here. So when the work will be zero? When there will be no displacement, even application of the force. Then that is called the zero work. Then we will come to the this is the various types of work. So work is over. Now we will enter to the energy part. What is energy? Capability or ability to do work is called the energy. Energy meaning is very different. That is capability or ability to do work. When we want to do some work, we must have some ability, capability. If we do not have that ability or capability, even applying the force, we cannot do. So that ability to apply the force and to ability to do the work is known as the energy. So this is very simple. Capability or ability to do the work is known as the energy. So example I given here, when a striker hits the stationary carom coin, it sets the carom into motion. Here striker use the energy to displace carom, or when we take a table from one place to another place, we do work by using the energy. So when the striker, suppose carom board is there, we strike the coin. So when we strike the coin, we have to give the force and certain work is done. So that capability of doing that work is known as the energy. Or now I bring this table. So I bring one table to here. So that capability I have. Otherwise I could not give it the force. I cannot do the work, but I have that ability to do the work, so this is my energy. Some small boy, they may not take this one because they do not have the ability to do work. They do not have the energy to bring this table. So that's why capability is known as the energy. Let us come. Similarly, as we have done work SI unit, we have to go for the SI unit of the energy also. Same to work. SI unit of work is joule and energy also joule. So energy is a scalar quantity because there is no direction is applied in this energy. So any physical quantity without direction, only magnitude, that is called the scalar quantity, and both magnitude and the direction is known as the vector quantity. That's why this energy do not have any type of direction related. That's why it is called the scalar quantity. Let us see the types of energy. Like the work is positive, negative, zero. Similarly, energy is also different types. What are the types of energy? Potential energy. Mechanical energy, heat energy, chemical energy, sound energy, water energy, muscular energy, magnetic energy, electrical energy, nuclear energy. So many sources of energy are there. These are only the types of energy. But our syllabus deals with the mechanical energy. Mechanical energy, let us see. What is mechanical energy? Mechanical energy, two types. One is potential energy, one is kinetic energy. This is related to the body or the mass, physical mass of the body. The energy is known as the mechanical energy. So mechanical energy, two types. One is potential energy, another is known as the kinetic energy. Let us see. What is the difference between the potential energy and the kinetic energy? Potential energy, the energy possessed by a rest body, that is example, book lying on the table, fan in the rest, that is potential energy. So just you see, so the energy possessed by a rest body. Rest body means the body which is not moving, that is called the rest body. So the energy possessed by a rest body is known as the potential energy or PE. For example, look at this fan. This fan is just standing on the floor. It does not move, and this fan does not have any that possess the energy. What type of energy that fan possess? That is called the potential energy, because this fan does not run. So that is potential energy. You can see the board. The board does not move. It is stationary, rest. So it has the potential energy. You see the this what is called this duster. Duster lying on the table. It does not move. It has the potential energy. All the body has the energy. If it is rest, then that is called the potential energy. And potential energy formula is mgh. M for mass, g for acceleration due to gravity, and h for the height of the object from the surface. Then we will come to the kinetic energy. What is kinetic energy? The energy possessed by a moving body or the body in motion is called the kinetic energy. Example, running fan, running vehicle, blowing wind, flowing water, etc. So all they have the kinetic energy, because very simple, if the body is in the motion, his body is not rest but in the motion, the body is moving, that energy possessed by moving body or motion body is known as the kinetic energy. Look at the fan here. This fan, you just see this fan is rotating on the roof. Can you see? Yeah, that fan is rotating. Now this fan has the kinetic energy. But you see that fan. That fan does not rotate. You see that is standing on the floor simply. Rest So it has the kinetic energy, but the fan which is rotating, that has the it has the potential energy, and the rotating fan has the kinetic energy. Similarly, blowing wind, when air blows, that is the kinetic energy. Flowing water, that is the kinetic energy, but water which is stagnant, that has the potential energy. So in this way we can classify the potential energy and the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy formula, Ke is equal to half mv square. Half m is for mass, v is for velocity of the body or speed of the body. So this is about today's class. So we discussed today main points are work, structure, formula and SI unit, and types. Then types of work, then energy part. Energy we have definition, then SI unit, then types of energy. So that is finished. So today's class over. So we'll meet again next class. Till that, goodbye.